Welcome to Mainland 5WH channel. In today's session, we will talk about a specific database called as Azure Cosmos DB. Now, having worked with Microsoft and as well as having used their technologies for a very long time, Cosmos DB is a very interesting product to really review. Okay, so it's actually distributed, globally distributed, and horizontally scalable database service. Okay. So being given that data is the new oil in today's world, it has no value until it is processed, manipulated, okay, and used to derive some useful insights. So what Cosmos DB has, it has got a lot of functionalities. It's the next generation of Azure database, an enhanced version of document database. Okay. It's a globally distributed, multi-model, scale at the click of the button. It supports documents, table, and graph values together in a single database. Okay. So Cosmos DB was the earlier known as Document DB, designed to store semi-structured data such as documents, typically in JSON or XML format. So unlike traditional relational, the schema for each of this non-relation can vary, giving developers, DBAs, and IT more flexibility in organizing and storing data and reducing the storage complexity. So Cosmos DB is also called as a planet scale database, good choice for any serverless application that needs low order of millisecond response times and if you want to scale rapidly and globally. Okay, basically if you really want to go a bit of history, it came out of a project in Microsoft called Project Florence, which began in 2010. And then it was the first commercialized in 2015 with the release of NoSQL called Azure Document DB, and Cosmos DB was introduced in 2017. Okay, so it's a service that is globally distributed, management of data even if it is stored in data centers that are scattered throughout the world. It provides a tool needed to scale both global distribution patterns and also computers that are provided by Microsoft Azure. So why should you use Cosmos DB, and why am I reviewing this at the first point? Number one, it has no data scheme and it's schema free. So it indexes all the data without requiring schema and index management. That's pretty interesting, number one. Number two, it is also a multi-model, natively supporting document, key value, graph, and column family data model. And it is industry's first globally distributed, horizontally scalable, multi-model database. Okay. It guarantees single digit millisecond latency at the 99th percentile anywhere in the world. Okay, and you don't have to worry about the instances like server, CPU, or memory. And you can just select the throughput, the required storage, and create the collections. It's integrated with Azure Functions. It's a serverless, event-driven solution. It's got an API and access methods. Comes with DocumentDB API, Graph API, which is Gremlin, MongoDB API, RESTful HTTP API, and Table API. So this gives you a lot of flexibility for a developer. You also observe that it's very elastic, globally scalable. It's got different levels, right? Bounded, stateless, consistent prefix, session consistency, blah, blah, blah. So I would really look at this as one of the leadership thing from Microsoft. This news is a strong community also building up, and let's see now how the product looks like from what Microsoft is speaking from the leader directly. So this is how you will see the database. You can have Azure Cosmos DB. It's called as a fast NoSQL database open. So you can start free. You can actually sign in. I'll show you a demo later, but just you can start free if you want. So basically, this is what we discussed now. Fully managed NoSQL, modern app development, guaranteed single digit millisecond response time, 99.99% availability backed by SLAs, automatic instance scalability. Okay, so these are some of the things like guaranteed speed at scale, fast flexible app development for popular languages like MongoDB, Cassandra, Gremlin, no ETL analytics, ready for mission critical application, fully manageable and cost effective, right? And this is very interesting, you have an app user, there's a traffic manager, which we all know from Azure Traffic Manager Global Service. Then there are different web app at different regions. They enter the traffic into the, you can have the Azure Cosmos DB with the app and session data. Okay, so you can have transparent multi-master replication across the three regions, what has been shown here. Okay. At the back end, you can see that there is Azure Active Directory, App Insights, and Key Vault. Okay. You can, an example here is like you can do a real-time IoT device telemetry. You can scale instantly and elastic to accommodate diverse and unpredictable IoT workloads without sacrificing ingestion or query performance. You can stream vehicle telemetry for smart fleet solutions, stream and analyze data with change feed for real-time. Like Mercedes-Benz, ExxonMobil, and Olympus are among the market, they rely on Azure Cosmos DB to power IoT solutions. You can see here in this diagram, the real-time historical operation modeling, which is using Power. This is the visualization bit, which you have Power BI, Stream Analytics, Event Hub. Okay, you have the Azure function. From the Cosmos DB, you can call a function, which is in turn going and giving you the interface. The logistics manager has got a handle to this particular reporting. And the Power BI has got the inputs from the Azure also goes to Power BI as well as go to the operational portal. Okay. And then you can also embed this with your Azure Databricks, which is the Spark processing pipeline to model publication to the Azure Kubernetes service. And you can create the machine learning pipeline here. And then you can see here, like there is a vital telemetry Azure IoT Hub function, which also comes into the Cosmos DB. You can downstream the system integration by using the Azure function and logic app, and you can have things like App Insights, Key Vault, etc. You can also do real-time retail services. So that's some of the real things about this particular thing. Okay, it's designed for developers, support for a wide range of APIs, SQL API, Cassandra API, and blah, blah, blah. Okay. And then if you really see, if you want to really go deeper into it, you can go to its documentation. Basically, it's you can actually do Cosmos. It's got key value, column, family, document, and graph. Okay. And it's simplified application development. So this is very important for us. You can build fast with open source API, deeply integrated with Azure services used in modern cloud, native app development, including Azure Function, IoT Hub, Azure Kubernetes Service, App Service, and more. You can choose from multiple database API. Okay. You can build app on the core using language of your choice. You can use SDKs for .NET, Java, Node.js, or Python, right? So that's very interesting. And you can have mission critical, blah, blah, blah. Then you can really look at this, right? So you can have a refer. There are a lot of samples, concepts, and how you can look at. So that's a very brief about this Cosmos DB. I would strongly recommend that you really watch this database, because it's going to be very interesting for the future.